Chapter 9. Once the tape was ready, Arthur couldn't wait to get it into the mail. He sent the band home with his promise to let everyone know as soon as he heard anything. "We are going to be rich," said Buster. Arthur shook his head. "Buster, the prize doesn't include any money." "Oh, well, we'll be famous then. I can be flexible." He took twice on his tuba and headed for home. Arthur went into the house to get the package ready. He wrote a quick letter and put it in an envelope with the tape. Grandma Tora helped him figure out how many stamps we needed. Then he went back outside. Where are you going, Arthur?" asked D.W. She and Nadine were playing in the snow. "Can talk now, D.W. I'm in a hurry." His sister put the package under his arm. "Oh, is that the jingle for the contest? I hear you playing something before." Arthur looked down at the package. "This? Oh, yes, I guess so. So, what did you come up with? Let's hear it." "You don't have to be public, D.W. I know you and Nadine aren't interested." "Nadine does like when you put words in her mouth, Arthur. She'll like to decide things for herself." "Good for her," said Arthur. "But really, I mean," D.W. frowned. "You like the song, don't you?" "Oh, yes, very much. Well, sing it to me." "Oh, munch, crunch, snap, crackly, pop, something like that." "Oops, look at the time. I don't want to miss the rest mail pickup." D.W. wouldn't have said more, but Arthur was no longer there to hear it. D.W. turned back to Nadine. Sometimes her brother was more than a little strange. She sugared, hoping it was contagious. As Arthur headed down the street, he slowed to walk. He was advised telling D.W. when the jingle had come from. Of course, she didn't even know she had helped him. So then, there was no reason to tell her. No, really. Great artists were always taking impressions from the people and place around them. Arthur was on the stage in a concert setting in the park. He was sitting in front of a piano. A cheer crowd couldn't be heard in the background. He played the theme to the jingle and flashed a big grin. The crowd cheered. Many rows back, D.W. was pushing her way to the stage. Arthur, I know that song. Did you two tell the truth?" Arthur heard his sister's voice, but couldn't see her. "D.W., where are you?" D.W. had almost reached the stage, but before she couldn't climb the stairs, several people rushed forward to block her way. "Who was that?" asked the beefy head of secretary. "Oh, just one of my many fans," said Arthur. Some of them can be very determined." Arthur sighed. He had arrived at the mailbox. What he had to do was drop in the envelope. "Just put down the handle and drop it in. Nothing to it, really." But someone he couldn't know yet, he just stood there blinking in the sunlight.